Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, the great Tay Tay. And as you can see from the title of this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a frontal wig on a sewing machine. So this video, it's highly requested. So as you can see here, I placed my mesh dome cap on my canvas block head. And right now I'm just working on my measurements. So the measurement for this wig from forehead, from the front to back, it is 13. So that's what I'm doing there. I'm just marking it off. So I start from the front and I measure to the back. It's 13, and I'm just double checking just to ensure that it's accurate. And from side to side, it is 12 inches. So that's what I'm doing there, just marking it off. And I'm using my T-pins to mark the spots. So as you can see now, that's the excess space on the mesh dome cap. So what I'm gonna do, because I want the wig to be snatched, right? So I'm just resizing the wig cap, the mesh dome cap, to ensure that the wig fits like a glove. So I kind of like grab, you know, that excess spacing, and I just move it towards the area at the front, and it should look like that, you know, as you can see there. And I'm just sewing it down, you guys. So don't worry, whenever the wig is done, the stitches, it won't pull out, because remember that we're gonna use the sewing machine to go over these stitches, you know, from side to side whenever we start sewing the wig. So right here, I'm just sewing this area down, and there's no specific way to sew it down. Just sew it down as long as it's sewn down, right? Because, you know, this part, we're probably gonna cut this area off when the wig is completed, because it's a frontal wig. So with a frontal wig, all this excess mesh at the front, it's gonna be cut off when the wig is completed. Also, you guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet subscribed, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you can be notified whenever I upload any new content. And leave a comment in the comment section below, you guys. Let me know if this video was helpful, and also let me know of any other type of videos that you guys want me to create for you. be creating guidelines, water guidelines. These lines are the lines that I use that kind of like guides me whenever I'm sewing on the sewing machine. And I use, in order to draw my guidelines, it's kind of like a finger width apart, you know. I kind of like eyeball it because I've been doing this for a long time, but it's normally a thumb width apart, you guys. And this crayon that I'm using, it's just a Crayola regular crayon. It's nothing special or anything like that. So these are my guidelines. This is what my guidelines look like. So you can mimic my guidelines. It works for me. And now I am gonna start sewing my tracks onto my mesh dome cap. So just letting you know that my tracks, I've already doubled my tracks off camera. I also have a video, a very detailed video on how to double your tracks. I'll link that in the description below so you can check that video out as well. So now I am just sewing on my guidelines. So I start with sewing front stitch, back stitch, maybe like twice or three times, and then I start sewing across. And then when I'm at the other end, I do a front stitch, back stitch again, and then I cut my track, and then I am on to the other guideline. When you're sewing, try your best not to stretch your cap. You guys, do not stretch your cap, because if you stretch your cap, it's gonna affect the way, the size of your wig, okay? So just focus on the area that's being sewn and ensure that area is flat, and just let the sewing machine do its thing, okay? No need to stretch your cap, no need to fight with the sewing machine. Just let the sewing machine do its thing and just gently push, you know, just gently push the wig forward while you're sewing. You don't need to be tussling with the sewing machine. Also, you don't need to be sewing really fast. Just take your time, go at your own pace. No one's rushing you, no one's racing you. Just take your time and do your thing, okay? Quite a few people have been asking me where I got that blade from. I got it from my local dollar store, you guys. But I believe you can get it from Michael's. Yeah, I believe Michael's, they have blades like the one that I'm using. And it comes with like 10 additional blades. So whenever one gets dull, you can replace it with another one. So you guys get the concept of what I'm doing here. I am just sewing on the guidelines that I've created. And that's pretty much what I am doing at this point. So later down in the video, I will be showing you guys how I plucked the frontal and styled the frontal. So I'll see you guys later down in the video. And also, you guys, I'll be showing you how I added the elastics to my wig as well. So later on in the video, you will see that. Here I'm done sewing my wig, y'all. This is what the inside of my wig looks like. Only need stitches around here. So I'm gonna cut the excess mesh from the front of the wig. And when you're cutting this area, try your best not to cut the mesh on your, try your best not to cut your lace. So you don't wanna cut the lace on your wig because you don't wanna spoil your wig. And just so you guys know, I already bleached the frontal. So I already bleached the knots on my frontal. I'll also link a video below on how to bleach your knots. I have a detailed video on that as well, you guys. So here I'm gonna show you how I added my elastic bands to my wig. So what I do, I use a rat tail comb to kind of like just to separate the hair at the front, and then I'm gonna place my elastic band on that area, and then I'm gonna sew it down. And I'm gonna use the stitch that I'm using, it's a straight stitch, okay? So I'm using a straight stitch to secure the elastic band onto the lace. And I don't think I mentioned this earlier in my video, but I used a zigzag stitch to sew my tracks onto my wig. So I used a zigzag stitch, and I'll link all that information in the section below.